Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Dutch chipmaker ASML, which posted a jump in revenue and profit in the second quarter, beating analysts' expectations. ASML shares are trading in the green at 667.3 euros apiece. Also in focus, shares of Carvana, which reversed earlier losses after reporting its best ever quarter for profit. Shares of the U.S. online used car retailer plunged nearly 8% in pre-market trade after moving up its earnings release, but managed to recover, soaring over 17% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Johnson & Johnson after it was ordered to pay $18.8 million to a man who said he developed cancer from exposure to its baby powder. J&J shares are down 0.4% in pre-market trade.
Asia markets ended Wednesday closed mostly higher on Wednesday after gains on Wall Street overnight. Japan's Nikkei jumped 1.2%. That's even as a Reuters Sankan survey showed business sentiment among manufacturers in Japan declined for the first time in 6 months in July. China growth concerns, however, remain in investors' minds, dragging the Hong Kong Hang Seng down 0.3%. Some notable stock movements in the region. Property shares in Hong Kong fell after China Evergrande, the real estate giant behind Beijing's property crisis, reported it lost $81 billion in 2 years, while its debt rose to $340 billion. Over in India, shares of the Tata Group jumped 1.3% as it announced it will build an electric vehicle battery plant in the UK, its first outside India, with an investment of £4 billion. Here at home, Philippine shares posted modest gains. The main index picked up 0.5% to close at 65.41. China Bank Security says the challenge now is for the index to stay above 6,500.
Hopefully, we've seen the last of significant selling pressure due to profit taking. For now, we think that the key catalysts that may lead to a potential market breakout is dovish or less hawkish pronouncements from the Fed. Another catalyst that we're looking at is continuing net foreign buying. If we don't have those conditions, or if we don't see those conditions materialize, then we may see a continued market consolidation for now.
NEDA Board approved several infrastructure projects, including the solicited proposal for the rehabilitation of Manila's main gateway, the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. This means the board has de facto closed a 267 billion peso unsolicited bid presented by the mega consortium of the country's biggest conglomerates. Jackie Pascual has the details.
NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan announced that the board approved the solicited proposal to rehabilitate, operate, expand, and transfer the Ninoy Aquino International Airport PPP project under the Department of Transportation and the Manila International Airport Authority, with a total project cost of 170.6 billion pesos. It aims to increase the current annual airport capacity to 62 million from 35 million. NEDA said this automatically closed the track for the 267 billion peso unsolicited proposal of Manila International Airport Consortium to operate and rehabilitate NAIA.
The unsolicited track is already closed, at least for this project. Ensure that those unsolicited contracts that are still live would have to be returned. Open and competitive bidding, usually for the benefit of the public and the government, because we don't know what's best until we get the various offers.
The approved solicited proposal has a 15-year term with a possible 10-year extension. Balisacan explained, even if the MIA consortium offered a higher price of over 200 billion pesos, it is not necessarily the better option. He now hopes the consortium, which includes top conglomerates like Aboitiz, InfraCapital, PhilInvest, and JG Summit, will join the bidding.
Hindi lang yung total amount yung titingnan mo yan. That nominal pa, ang importante rin yung present value ng stream. No? Kasi maaari ding 300 billion pero ang nasa dulo pala yung spending.
The consortium for its part said it understands the decision of NEDA and that it is aligned with the government's commitment to the urgent task of revitalizing NAIA. The consortium did not say if it will join the bidding. Other projects approved by the NEDA board are the Samar Pacific Coastal Road 2 project worth 7.48 billion pesos and the unsolicited Lagindingan Airport PPP project worth 12.75 billion pesos. Balisakan meanwhile said the NAIA project is one of the priority infrastructure projects of the government, which are now listed at the new Infrastructure Flagship Projects dashboard online. He said the country is also on track to become an upper-middle-income country, but it also means the Philippines may lose perks such as official development assistance given to low-income economies.
The price of becoming an upper-middle-income economy is that you lose this access to concessional loans. So we are already preparing for that eventuality. No? One of those is for example, getting our PPP more robust. The Maharlika project initiative is also aimed at that, for that.
Balisakan asserts he would rather choose becoming an upper middle income country over having access to loans, as that would mean a higher standard of living for Filipinos. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.